गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू आवर ऑनलाइन ई लर्निंग क्लास। दिस इज योर पॉलिटिकल साइंस पीरियड। आई होप बोथ माय स्टूडेंट्स आर वॉचिंग दिस वीडियो। स्टूडेंट्स, वी हैव स्टार्टेड दैट इज चैप्टर 4, कंटेम्पररी साउथ एशिया। And we have covered up to India and Pakistan conflicts. Till that topic we have already covered. Now in today's video, we will move forward and we will cover two important topics from this chapter. That is India and its other neighbors, and the next topic is peace and cooperation, India and its other neighbors or neighboring countries, and peace and cooperation. So these two topics we are going to cover in today's video. So students, you all know how many neighboring countries are there to India through land frontier. Means 7 countries. What are they? Pakistan, Afghanistan, China, नेपाल, भूटान, बांग्लादेश, म्यांमार। सो दीज 7 कंट्रीज आर हैविंग लैंड फ्रंटियर विथ इंडिया, एंड अवर ओशनिक नेबर्स आर श्रीलंका एंड मालदीव्स। ऑलरेडी वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट बांग्लादेश, अबाउट नेपाल, above with Pakistan, with Sri Lanka. These topics already we have covered. Now we are moving forward and looking into the topic India and its other neighbors. Here we'll do the comparison between India and our neighboring countries. The governments of India and Bangladesh had differences over several issues, including the sharing of the Ganga and Brahmaputra river waters. That means, though India and Bangladesh both are neighbors to each other, or I can say, though Bangladesh is a neighboring country to India, though India helped Bangladeshi people during the war with Pakistan in 1971, but still both Indian governments and Bangladesh government both are having conflicts over several issues. Okay, both are having differences over several issues, particularly the sharing of river Ganga water, the sharing of river Brahmaputra water, the Rohingyas problem, the refugees, the Rohingyas problem. So these problems are there with Bangladesh. Despite their differences, though we are having differences with each other, so despite their differences, India and Bangladesh do cooperate on many issues. See, one way we are having differences, we are having conflicts over several issues, at the same time we are cooperating with each other over several issues. We have economic relations with Bangladesh. We have economic relations with Bangladesh. So economic relations have improved considerably in the last 10 years. In the last 10 years or 10 to 15 years, the economic relations between India and Bangladesh were improved despite the above conflicts. Bangladesh is a part of India's Look East policy. Look East policy. Look East policy. So, Bangladesh is a part of India's Look East policy that wants to link up, that wants to link up the Southeast Asia via Myanmar. I'll repeat the sentence. Students, listen carefully. Bangladesh is a part of India's Look East policy. Bangladesh is a part of India's Look East policy that wants to link up the Southeast Asia via means what? Through Myanmar. Here Myanmar means what? Earlier it is called Burma. On disaster management. You know disaster management. When the disaster management will be active, whenever there will be any natural calamities, floods, droughts, tsunami. Okay, like this. So on disaster management and environmental issues, the two states, India and Bangladesh, both the states have cooperated regularly. That means whenever there is any natural calamities or environmental problem, at the time both the states cooperated with each other. Now let's move to Nepal. What is the relation between India and Nepal? Nepal government we have studied. Nepal rule we have studied. The transition from monarchy to constitutional monarchy and from constitutional monarchy to democracy we have studied. Now see. Nepal and India enjoys a very special relationship. Nepal and India enjoys a special relationship that has very few parallels in the world. We have very good and friendly relations with Nepal. Both countries cooperating with each other. So many Nepalese, they came to India and they are working here. They got employment here. There is no need of visa to go to, or passport needs to go to Nepal or to come to India. So you have very good chemistry, very good industry with each other. So Nepal and India enjoys a very special relationship that has very few parallels in the world. Such relation you cannot see in other countries. A treaty between the two countries allows the citizens of the two countries to travel each other and work in the other country without what? Visa and passport. As I told you, both the countries agreed that the Indian people can go to Nepal, Nepal people can come to India, and the government restrictions are not there regarding passport and visa. That much very good relations we have between India and Nepal. Indian government has often expressed displeasure. Indian government always expressed displeasure at the warm relationship with Nepal and China. Sometimes Nepal and China also maintaining the relations. So when Nepal and China, they maintained the relations, that became an eyesore to Indian government. So that's why it showed its displeasure. not pleasure, displeasure. So Indian government has often, regularly, Indian government has often showed the displeasure or expressed the displeasure at the warm relation, warm, very cordial relation between Nepal and China, and at the Nepal's government inaction against the anti-Indian elements that implace Maoists. Maoists are from Nepal. The beginning of Maoists started in Nepal. Students, you remember this one. Maoists. You are hearing that Sukma, Bijapur, this area, Maoist people attacked on the CRPF jawans. This Maoism, Maoist, actually, Nepal is the heart of the Maoist. But actually, in China, one ruler was there, Mao Zedong, or Mao Zedong, or Mao. He is the leader of Chinese Communist Party. Mao, or Mao Zedong, or Mao Zedong, is the Chinese Communist Party leader. Okay, he encouraged Maoism, and Nepal became the center of that one. From Nepal, many people are entering into Bihar, from Bihar to Jharkhand, from Jharkhand to Chhattisgarh. In this way, they are coming. And they're seated in the border of Maharashtra, Andhra Pradesh and Chhattisgarh. So what I want to say, so India always showed displeasure when Nepal kept warm relations with what? China. And also, at the Nepal's government inaction, Nepal government is not at all taking any action. Nepal government is not at all taking any action against the Maoism in their country, for which India showed the displeasure with Nepal. Okay, Nepal thinks that the Indian government, Nepal thinks that the Indian government interferes, or I can say, Nepal thinks that the Indian government interferes in its internal affairs. Actually, we are telling to Nepal government, please do something. Please control Maoism, Maoist activities, like that we are informing Nepal, telling Nepal. But Nepal, how it reacted? It always thought that unnecessarily, Indian government is interfering in their internal matters. Like that it received. Okay, so Nepal thinks that the Indian government interferes in its internal affairs and has designs on its river waters and hydroelectricity. Hydroelectric power generation is more in Nepal because it is a hilly area, rugged topography. So Nepal people believe that unnecessarily Indian government is interfering in their domestic affairs, in their internal affairs, and also wants the share of river waters and also hydroelectricity, and prevents Nepal, a landlocked country. Das is a landlocked country, Nepal. All the four sides, it is surrounded by high mountains. Landlocked. We will hear this word in geography. Landlocked harbor, Vishakhapatnam harbor, landlocked harbor. So like that here, landlocked country, Nepal. So, a landlocked country from getting easier access to the sea through Indian territory. Suppose if Nepal wants to trade with any foreign country through ship, definitely Nepal has to approach Indian government. They have to come to Bihar, they have to come to West Bengal, then they have to go to Calcutta port or Orissa Paradip port. So Nepal country is getting access to sea water only through India. That Nepal is forgetting. I repeat, Nepal thinks that the Indian government interferes in their internal affairs and has designs on its river water and hydroelectricity. That means Nepal thinks that we want to take the river water. We will demand a share in the hydroelectricity from the country. And prevents Nepal, a landlocked country. We are not allowing Nepal to keep connection with the other countries. Okay. From getting easier access into the sea through Indian territory. Nepal blames India that the Indian government is not allowing Nepal country to access to the sea water for trade and other purposes. That is the way Nepal government is blaming Indian government. The difficulties in the relation between the governments of India and Sri Lanka. Now we are going to Sri Lanka. Both are democratic countries, right from the beginning of their independence. Okay, but they adopted majoritarianism. We have not adopted that one. Ours is a secular country. We treat all the people equally. So that now relationship between India and Nepal. So India and Sri Lanka. The difficulties in the relationship between the governments of India and Sri Lanka are mostly over the ethnic conflict in the island nation. Ethnic conflict was there, that they told you. There is a problem between Sinhala people and the Indian Tamils and the Sri Lankan Tamils. So since the ethnic problem, when it started, soon after war, 1948, after independence, from that time till date, we had relations with what? Sri Lanka. So the difficulties in the relationship between the governments of India and Sri Lanka are mostly over ethnic conflicts in the island nation. Here Sri Lanka is an island nation. India always advises, suggests the Sri Lankan government not to do any sort of discrimination over Indian Tamils, not to have a bad treatment towards Indian Tamils. But Sri Lankan government ignores that one. Indian government always urges to treat the Indian Sri Lankans properly, not to neglect them, to give all the privileges equivalent to Sinhalas. But the Sri Lankan government is not at all accepting that one. They are showing biased between Sinhalas and this Indian Tamils. India's help in post-tsunami reconstruction. I mean, when tsunami struck in 2004, at that time India helped a lot to Sri Lankan country for their recovery, reconstruction, reformation. So India's help in the post-tsunami reconstruction in Sri Lanka has also brought the two countries closer. Actually, during Rajiv Gandhi time, the relation was sometimes good, sometimes sour. Bitter and sour. But from 2004 onwards, the relation between India and Sri Lanka was little bit friendly, cordially, because India helped Sri Lanka in the post reconstruction of tsunami. India enjoys a very special relationship. Now I am moving to some other country. Relation between India and Bhutan. India and Bhutan, our neighboring country. It is bordering Sikkim and Assam and Arunachal Pradesh. Bhutan, capital Thimphu. So India enjoys a very special relationship with our neighboring country, Bhutan. Okay, India enjoys a special relationship with our neighboring country, Bhutan. And does not have any major conflict. We are not having any conflicts with this neighboring country, Bhutan, a small country, Bhutan. Okay, with the Bhutanese government. That means there is no conflicts between Indian government and the Bhutanese government. It is a neighboring country. Unlike Nepal, unlike China, unlike Sri Lanka, unlike Bangladesh, we had very good relations with what? Bhutan. Next, India is involved in big hydroelectric projects in Bhutan. I mean, both India and Bhutan country both signed an agreement. With that agreement, with the collaboration of both the countries, several hydroelectric projects are being constructed in that area. Okay, in that area, so that the benefits can be shared by both the countries. Okay, so India is involved in big hydroelectric projects in Bhutan and remains the Himalayan Kingdom's biggest source of development aid. Bhutan is the Himalayan Kingdom, the biggest source of India is involved in big hydroelectric projects between Bhutan and India, and Bhutan remains the Himalayan Kingdom's biggest source of development aid. Now we'll move to our next topic, that is peace and cooperation. In spite of many conflicts, the states of South Asia